In this part of our spotter training, we'll talk about supercell variations. We'll talk about the difference between classic and high precipitation supercells, and we'll discuss the tornado life cycle. Classic supercells are the ones that have potential for long track tornadoes, 10 to 20 miles in length. Typically, these are easier to see. These are the ones that most frequently we'll see pictures from out on the plains where you can see the tornado for 20, 30 miles away. However, here in central Illinois, most of our supercells tend to be in the high precipitation category. Rain surrounds the mesocyclone, and any rotation subsequently is usually hidden by the heavy precipitation. In this particular image in the lower right, you cannot see exactly where the tornado is occurring. These type of supercells are very dangerous to spot. Looking at a cross-section of a supercell, we have the mesocyclone in the middle, associated with the tilted updraft. On the front, we'll have the front flank downdraft. That's the area that's producing the precipitation, and often we'll have gusty winds with it. We have the rear flank downdraft in the back. That's associated with a rain-free base, and that's the area where the tornado would form. However, even if a thunderstorm is rotating, only a fraction of supercells will produce tornadoes. The important point to understand with classic supercells is that you need to stay on the southern flank of the storm with the inflow at your back. You should stay at least 2 or 3 miles or more from the rotating clouds. This is an example of how our supercell looks like on radar. This particular example was the Washington tornado from November 17, 2013. The hook echo is part of the mesocyclone, but it is not necessarily a tornado. The precipitation shield, as you can see here, is extending well to the northeast, and that actually is the direction of storm movement off to the northeast. The rear flank downdraft, even though the precipitation is tapering off here, does have very gusty winds with it. When you're spotting a classic supercell, watch for a clearing area near the wall cloud and a developing funnel cloud. This is called the rear flank downdraft, or what we call an RFD, or clear slot. And the images on the right, you can see this forming. Here is the clear spot up here. And here's the funnel cloud that is forming. Also keep an eye out for rotation and dust whirls at the ground. As you can see, the actual funnel is not filled in yet. However, we are getting that dust swirl on the bottom. That is the beginning of the tornado. Here's an example of a tornado at its mature stage. This is the most dangerous stage of the tornado. Be sure to watch for debris with the tornado, which may hide the fact that it is still in contact with the ground. This particular example here, you cannot really see whether the point of the tornado is touching the ground, but you can still see all the debris that's being kicked up with it. Toward the end of its life cycle, what we call the rope stage of a tornado, you can see how skinny this is. However, it does still have powerful wind speeds. Be sure to watch out for another tornado to form within a few miles or so downstream of this one. Here's another example. This is what we refer to as a cyclic supercell. We have our main tornado here, right in the middle of the picture. However, notice off to the right here, we have another funnel cloud that's starting to form. That's developing into a new tornado, and the old tornado is weakening. Here's a side view of an HP supercell. Our tilted updraft is going basically into the screen. We have our rotating mesocyclone with it. And notice the precipitation shield that's associated with it. You cannot exactly see where the rotation is occurring in the lowest levels of the atmosphere. Keep in mind with HP supercells that because the precipitation is surrounding any potential tornado activity, the safest place to spot is on the south flank of the storm. The mesocyclone and the tornado are usually associated at the front of the storm in the notch area. This particular example up near Rockford, Here is the notch located just to the southeast of Lake Somerset. Often this will have a kidney bean shape on radar. Here's a sequence of pictures from Gifford, Illinois, on the same day as the Washington tornado, November 17, 2013. This is what it looked like a few minutes before the tornado formed. We have a wall cloud in the center of the picture. Here we have our tornado touching down, 12:45 p.m. A minute later, still see it very well. Looks even more impressive another minute after that. Another minute after that, pretty wide, a lot of debris being thrown about by it. 12:49 here, it's starting to become a little fuzzier, but you can still make it out. However, by the next minute, it's very hard to make it out in this area because it's becoming wrapped in rain from the southwest.